In this video, you'll learn about CloudFormation Drift and why you should avoid it in infrastructure as code-based applications. So in order to understand why drift is a problem, we first need to review some basic infrastructure as code-based concepts. So I think everyone understands IAC or infrastructure as code by now. With IAC, you create your infrastructure using a programming or templating language. Now, this has a whole bunch of benefits, including making it easier to duplicate environments and making infrastructure changes go through the code review process. All in all, infrastructure as code is a powerful new paradigm that most new teams and application developers are moving towards. Now, one of the unsaid rules of working with IAC-based applications is that you're only ever supposed to change your infrastructure through the code or the templating language that you're using. No more changing settings in a console, UI, or a CLI. Everything needs to be done through the code in order for you to maintain consistency. But unfortunately, whether it be for testing or some kind of emergency hotfix, someone always ends up messing with the settings outside of the code. And this is where drift comes in. Now, it's important to note that drift is a concept that can apply to any IAC provider, and this includes things like AWS CloudFormation and others such as Terraform. But in this video, I'm going to focus on drift in the context of AWS CloudFormation. So now that we have some context, let's quickly review what CloudFormation Drift is. So CloudFormation Drift is when infrastructure defined within your code is modified outside of that code. So for example, if you create a DynamoDB table or a Lambda function using CloudFormation and someone comes and modifies with the settings of that Lambda function outside of that CloudFormation template file, that's when drift will occur. So it sounds pretty innocent, like what's the problem with that? But it turns out there's a whole bunch of different problems that come with CloudFormation Drift. The first one being update errors. So this happens quite a bit when people mess with settings in the console or through the CLI. Things like changing a particular setting or changing a permission for a resource to access another resource. These are seemingly innocent things at the time that can result in some problems later. Now, this doesn't seem that bad at face value, but trying to debug these errors that are a result of CloudFormation drift can be very, very frustrating and very time consuming. So it's obviously something you want to avoid. Now, the other problem is that you compromise your ability to replicate a stack. So I think we all know one of the main benefits of using infrastructure as code is that you can develop one stack in a certain regional area and then pick that up and deploy that very easily into another stack because all of those resources are defined using your code. Now, if you run into a scenario where you have drift between what your stack actually is in code and what it is in reality, then that becomes a problem for replicating. So that's another big problem with CloudFormation drift. And the last reason is just a whole bunch of frustration and wasted time. Like I said earlier, you get a lot of cryptic errors. It's very unclear what's actually wrong with your stack when you encounter these kinds of scenarios. And often it just makes more sense to tear down the entire stack and then bring it back up again in a fresh new state. Believe me, I've been there and done that. So that's a little bit about what CloudFormation drift is. Now I want to talk about how to actually go about fixing drift. Now it turns out that there's two distinct ways to solve drift in the context of CloudFormation and any other IAC provider. So assume that you have a resource that you created in CloudFormation or through infrastructure as code, and then you modify that resource. Maybe you change a setting like the memory utilization from 50 to 75. So one of the ways that you can fix this is that you can change what you have in your code to match what the person did via the console. So you can change in your code base that setting, that memory setting from 50 to 75 so that it matches what exists in reality. This is one way to do it. And the other way is pretty much the other way around. Modifying the setting of the resource itself to match what you already have in your CloudFormation or CDK code. So those are the two key ways to do this. But the problem is, like, how do we know exactly what changed? Now, some of you may be able to figure this out through many, many hours of debugging CloudFormation error logs, and this certainly is possible, but there is a much better way that makes this a whole lot easier. And the answer is to use CloudFormation drift detection. So drift detection is a relatively new feature. So let's quickly talk about what it is and why it's important. So in essence, drift detection is a tool that scans your CloudFormation stack and its related resources to detect differences between those two things. This will tell you what is different between your infrastructure's code-based template and the resource itself as it exists in reality. So in order to use drift detection, it's very, very simple in CloudFormation. You just head over to the console into your stack. You go to the stack action settings like you can see here, and you just click on detect drift. This will launch a wizard where you just launch this process, and eventually it'll spit out some results whether or not drift was detected or not. If drift was detected, between what CloudFormation thought the resource should look like and what it actually looked like. So here's an example in this case here. If we take a look at some of the differences that CloudFormation Drift identified, we could see there's three key ones here. There's billing mode, not equal. The expected value in our code was provisioned and the actual value was pay per request. And some of these settings are a little bit different as well, as you can see here. And then within our template itself, you can see it's highlighting the difference. You can see there's provisioned and pay per request as we saw up here. So this was a little bit about what CloudFormation Drift is and why you should avoid it. If you want to learn more about CloudFormation, check out these other videos on the left and right. And thanks so much for watching. I'll see you next time.